All right, fans, at this time, please welcome to the stage your South Carolina Athletics Director, Coach Ray Tanner.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Welcome, Gamecocks. I know there's a noise ordinance in the city of Columbia, but I want to hear what it feels like to be a national champion. All of you helped us get here today, so it's time for you to take a bow. Listen to this. Number one in the nation for three straight years in attendance. Take a bow, all Gamecock fans. As you well know, around these parts, we compete to be great. At the University of South Carolina, whether you're a student or a student athlete, whether you're a business major, an education major, or listen to this, a double major in geography and marine science, who gets a Rhodes Scholarship. Let's hear it for Jory Fleming. And of course, if you play on the women's basketball team for Coach Dawn Staley, you can be the best in the country and the best in the world. Four straight regular season championships in the Southeastern Conference, three straight SEC tournament championships, and now the national championship. Listen to these numbers. Overall record, 33-4. And just in case you're wondering, Coach Staley's team has averaged 33 wins in each of the last three seasons. A few of the players that you might recognize: Asia Wilson. Final Four, most outstanding player, 23 points, 10 rebounds, and 4 blocked shots against Mississippi State. First team All-American by every organization, a finalist for the National Player of the Year, and a 2-time SEC Player of the Year. Alicia Gray, Final Four All-Tournament Team. On the All-Tournament Team, in the last game, 18 points, 10 rebounds, and 3 blocked shots against the Bulldogs. Let's hear it for Alicia Gray. Kayla Davis, Stockton Regional. Kayla was the most outstanding player in the Stockton Regional with 3 20-point games in the NCAA Tournament. Elena Coates, an honorable mention All-American. All-SEC, Elena Coates. And an All-SEC freshman, Taisha Harris. Now listen to this, our coach, when she was a player, she played in the Final Four 3 times. She was a National College Player of the Year twice. She was a 3-time Olympic gold medalist. She was a WNBA All-Star. She's been voted as one of the top 15 WNBA players of all time. And now she's a coach. She's been a head coach of the gold medal team in the Pan Am Games, the FIBA World Championship. She was a 2-time assistant coach on the gold medal Olympic teams. Now, she's a head coach of the USA national team. And the national championship coach at the University of South Carolina. What a player. What a coach. What a wonderful person. Let's hear it for Dawn Staley. It is now my honor to introduce a special guest today, a man that is instrumental in intercollegiate athletes across this country, who today had front row seats on the 18th hole at the Masters. But he chose to be here with us today. Please join me in welcoming to the City of Columbia and the University of South Carolina the Commissioner of the Southeastern Conference, Mr. Greg Sankey.
Yeah, let's go. SEC, right? Come on, everybody. Don't hold back. You are part of what makes this conference great. Those of you who support our teams, who line this parade route, who show up at our games, who comment online about officiating, who reminded me you don't want to play out west next year as I rode in a Porsche. I hear you. I don't make that decision, but I'll do what I can because we want to keep them close, don't we? This is my six straight weeks of being with the South Carolina basketball team. We started bringing the SEC Women's Basketball Tournament back to Greenville, where your team won the conference championship. We came back a week later, where your men's basketball team won two straight to advance to the Sweet 16. We took over New York City for a weekend for a basketball tournament. And then we as a conference had two teams in the national championship game in Dallas, Texas. And these ladies showed what a great team is on a national stage. All of that is a culmination of the support provided through this great university. The trustees, President Pastides, Ray Tanner is the athletics director, the faculty, the staff, players of the year, all conference team members, all Americans, all of whom form with you in this city and in this state a bond that is special and represents the best of the Southeastern Conference. To Coach Staley, to the ladies of the Gamecock Women's Basketball National Championship team, I say congratulations, and let's get used to success.
Win for us, and we're making history, but at the same time, we're not done. The best advice I can give them is to stay in the moment, stay the course. Don't do anything different because the stakes are a little bit higher. Just be yourself, be closer to yourself as possible. And then, you know, once the game sets in, you know, you'll feel it. It's like normal, it's like a normal game.
Play by Wilson. Quavash Moore, back strike for the Gamecocks. Around and out, guess who was the rebound? Right back up!
Hey, I work hard, pray hard, pay dues. Hey, I transform with pressure, I'm hands on with effort. I failed twice before.
My and South Carolina has won the national championship. For the first time in school history, NCAA champions.
What a game. Let's welcome home your South Carolina Gamecocks. Please welcome to the stage first your women's basketball coaching staff, Melanie Balcom, Fred Schmiel, Nikki McCray Penson, and Lisa Boyer. And now your Gamecock women's basketball student athletes. A junior transfer from Madison, Alabama, number 35, Alexis Jennings. A freshman from Orlando, Florida, number 0, Victoria Patrick. A freshman from Boston, Massachusetts, number 12, Arian Bradshaw. A freshman from Pembroke Pines, Florida, number 21, Kiki Herbert Harrigan. A sophomore from Newark, New Jersey, number 4, Danye Kleine. A senior from Houston, Texas, number 15, Tiffany Davis. A freshman from Noblesville, Indiana, number 52, Taisha Harris. A junior from the Bronx, New York, number 1, Bianca Cuevas Moore. A junior from Sandersville, Georgia, number 10, Alicia Gray. A junior from Sewanee, Georgia, number 3, Kayla Davis. A junior from Hopkins, South Carolina, number 22, Asia Wilson. And a senior from Irmo, South Carolina, number 41, Elena Coates. And finally, your 2017 Gamecocks women's basketball team head coach, Dawn Staley. This team has already done so much over the season, and Coach Tanner already talked about a few of their accomplishments, but let's look back and see some of the great moments from this season.
We can tell you everything we've accomplished, but why don't we let them show you?
And what a season it's been, and there are many people that are incredibly proud of this team. At this time, please welcome to the podium Richland County Council members.
Councilwoman Joyce Dickerson. Good afternoon. Go Cox! Go Cox! I am Councilwoman Joyce Dickerson, Chair of Richland County Council, and on behalf of my entire council, we are so proud of you today, our Lady Gamecocks, for being the nation's number one champion in the United States of America. Let's give it up for the Lady Gamecocks. And I am so proud of them. And on behalf of Richland County Council, we have prepared one of the most nicest plaques we think we could put together to honor our team today. And on behalf of my council members again, I will not read the entire plaque, but it says, congratulations to the University of South Carolina women basketball team 2016-2017 NCAA champions. Isn't that beautiful? Thank you. And again, I will present this to Coach Dawn Staley and her entire staff. Coach, we are so proud of you. Will you please come, and Elena and all of you come and receive this plaque on behalf of Richland County Council. So, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And on behalf of my two council members, who two of these team members happen to be in their district, and they wanted to take a moment to honor them as well. So on behalf of Richland County Council and my entire team, we thank you so much for allowing us this privilege.
Thank you, Councilwoman Dickerson. And just, we've got to recognize, we'd like to recognize a home product from Richland County. Irmo, South Carolina, Dutch Fork High School, Elena Coach, who was part of the team effort to get them all this far. Thank you, team.
Good afternoon. Asia. We're falling now. Asia, this is about family, community, and support. And on behalf of all members of Richland County Council and Hopkins, South Carolina, the Lower Richland community, we'd like to congratulate you and thank you for work well done. You and the Lady Gamecocks.
Thank you so
again,
much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you again to all the members of the Richland County Council, and thank you for your continuous support of the Gamecock Athletics Program. And now let's hear from your leader of Columbia, Mayor Steve Benjamin.
All right, guys. Game and Cox. Can we do it? Game! 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 I tell you what, there's nothing like throwing a party you know everyone's going to show up at. What a fantastic opportunity to celebrate the accomplishment of these young women and Coach Staley and her entire staff, the accomplishment of the University of South Carolina. On behalf of the City Council, we want to make sure that everybody knows that today is not just about basketball. These are champions, but we are so proud of them as student athletes, as incredible community servants. Some of them will go on to play pro basketball, some will be doctors, lawyers, mayors, congresspeople, governors, whatever they're gonna be, teachers, they're gonna do great things, and we are celebrating achievement by these young women today. On behalf of the grateful people of Columbia, so proud to be the home of the University of South Carolina and the county seat of Richland County, we want to ask Coach Staley to come up and make a special presentation and tell people that when they come to Columbia, South Carolina, from now on, You come on down to the Colonial Life Arena, you'll pass Lincoln Street from Pendleton to Assembly, which you'll hear for now be known as Dawn Staley Way. So proud. God bless you and keep you. I'm going to get out of the way so you can get to the ladies of the hour very soon. God bless you.
Thank you, Mayor Benjamin. Please now welcome to the stage Congressman Jim Clyburn.
Thank you very much, Dr. Pastides, to the athletic director, to the department, to all of the staffs, all of the administrators. Every year, I look for ways to give proper credit to people of South Carolina and most especially the 6th Congressional District. I am very proud that the University of South Carolina is in the 6th Congressional District, and I proudly represent them in the United States Congress. This year, I tried very hard to get the Congress to do a waiver and allow me a resolution, which they did not do. But what they could not stop me from doing is going to the floor of the United States House of Representatives and making remarks and entering into the record what I really felt about these Gamecock women. So, in volume number 163, number 59, page E463 of the Congressional Record, you will find the statement of what I really think about Coach Staley, her staff, these women, and the athletic department at the University of South Carolina. And over in the bag around here, each and every one of them will get a copy of this record. Hopefully they will keep it near and dear for the rest of their lives. Congratulations, Coach Staley. Congratulations, Ray Tanner. Congratulations, Dr. Pastides. I love you. I love representing you.
Thank you, Congressman Clyburn. Well, this team certainly has made the city and the state and fans and alumni from everywhere very proud. I can only imagine how it feels to be a student right now with another national championship. This university could not be more proud of the dedication and hard work of this team and the staff have put into this program. But I know one guy who's pretty close. Please help me welcome the University of South Carolina President, Harris Pastides.
Good afternoon, Columbia, or how it will be known from here on in, Gamecock City. I could not be more proud to be here with you today. Some people have said Columbia is the third best college city in America. Not after today, it's the best college town in America. As we were getting ready, Patricia asked me, are you really gonna put on that warm wool garnet jacket, tie, white shirt, and black pants for the parade? And I said, 3.5 weeks ago, the Lady Gamecocks played UNC Asheville in the regional. How many people here can even remember back that far? And I wore it. And I wore the same outfit as they beat Arizona State. And then we went to New York City and I wore the same thing as the men beat Marquette. And I went to Greenville and watched the men bring down Duke. and went to Madison Square Garden and wore the same outfit as the men took down Baylor. And the men took down Florida. And I wore it to Stockton, California. Now, I had to watch the women take down Quinnipiac on TV, but I wore the same thing. And then we went and watched the women become the regional champion against Florida State in California. And then we went to Dallas, Texas, and I wore the very same clothing. I did wash out a very few things. And I watched us as the women won that first game against the Stanford Cardinal. That was a great win. And then went to Phoenix, came back to Dallas as we won the national championship against Mississippi State. Ladies and gentlemen, I may never take these clothes off again. In closing, let me just say one thing. This women's basketball thing had three things going for them. Not me, them, and the coaches. Unity of purpose. Do you remember what their theme was this year? 100. 100. 100%. All in for the team. Not for me, but for us. They had that. Number two, they worked really hard. If you think this team won the national championship only based on talent or star quality, you would be wrong. They practiced hard every day. They worked hard. They cut no corners. And the third thing I'd like to say, they had a little magic as well. They had a childlike belief that anything was possible this year. No team would be against them. And we want to carry that childhood magical quality into the heart of the Gamecock Nation and everything we do. But let me tell you, you're about to hear from number 22 and from the coach. But let me tell you what they're thinking and likely will say. We have the best fans in the world. God bless you all.
I can't even put into words how grateful and blessed we are to be in this position. Y'all?
Sorry.
Anyways, just thank you so much for being loyal to us. Thank you for those who travel, those who watch at home, tweeting at us, the pictures. Just thank you for everything, because we really couldn't do this without y'all. There'll be games where it's really not going our way, but we hear the fans in Colonial, and y'all really speed us up, and we thank you for that. And thank you to the coaching staff for believing in us and yelling at us and all that good stuff. And just, I just can't even put into words how it was just a blessing to play with these group of girls. They are like my sisters, most definitely. I can't stand them sometimes, and I love them sometimes. So y'all, yeah, that's the tea. But thank you. Just, I can't even put in the words, just thank you. And just me being from here and just be able to bring a national championship back to the state of South Carolina. I mean, I tweeted out, I want to be like LeBron and bring one home. And I really couldn't do it without these group of girls and just a great coaching staff. And I want to thank my parents, most definitely. And I want to thank God. I wouldn't be anywhere without them. So, I mean, hey, we're trying to bring another one back next year, but we're going to celebrate this one. Thank you so much.
That was good.
In her ninth season as the head coach for the University of South Carolina women's basketball team, she's your 2017 national championship coach. Please welcome head coach Dawn Staley.
Hey girls. God is all things. He's all things. My cup is running over. Because it's been a tremendous season. We've had so much support from our president, who's at all of our games, and his wife, Mrs. Pestides, our AD, Ray Tanner, all of our administrators, our coaches, our colleagues have given us so much support to be in this position. And I, you know, it's a moment of reflection for me as a coach, as a teammate, as someone that's played in so many Final Fours and came up short, to my former players at Temple, to my former players at the University of South Carolina. They're the ones that believed in this well before we even had a legitimate shot at winning a national championship. I want to thank them from the bottom of my heart, and I hope they share in this moment, because they're very much a part of this moment that has taken place. I know I'm going to miss a lot of people. I know I am. But charge it to my head and not my heart. I'd like to thank our current players who had an incredible belief in themselves, an incredible belief in the challenge that they were faced with all season long. And they faced those challenges, you know, with incredible pride, South Carolina pride. And I know that I've been wearing this net. My netless. And it really has a significance, okay? And the significance has to do with all of you. All of you, all the little boys and little girls that live in the state of South Carolina and beyond. Figuratively, I want to give you all a piece of this net. Figuratively.
Got it.
Okay, so if you have any kind of belief, any kind of work ethic, any kind of hope, it represents that, because that's what it took for us to win a national championship. So it may not be a national championship, it may be to get to high school, it may be to go to college, it may be to get a promotion, it may be whatever it is that your heart's desire. Take a piece of our net and reflect on what we were able to accomplish, because nobody besides the people that are right here in the state of South Carolina, in the city of Columbia, believe that we could be standing here right now. So figuratively, take a piece of this net. Lastly, I do love my players, Bianca Cuevas. I love my players. Lastly, I want to thank the
come on, roll up here, Lay. Yo, my man, you're ruining the ceremony.
And lastly, because I know it's hot out here, but lastly, I just want to thank the mayor and the powers that be that recognized, and they gave me a street. That's never happened. My cup is running over, seriously. It's incredible what this state and this city has done for our team, for me personally, for our staff. I got to thank our staff. If our staff can step forward, everybody. Coach Boyer, Coach McCray, Coach Schmill, Coach Balcom. I gotta thank a lot of people. Our doctors, Dr. Guy, Dr. Murphy, Stella, Freddie Reddy, all of our managers. Reggie, our bus driver.
Big D, the sandwiches.
Big D, our office manager. Xavier, our academic advisor, because we did miss a lot of class over the past few weeks.
Katie,
Ari, CJ, everybody. I know Brad. I know I'm going to miss somebody, but it takes all of this. I got to give a shout out to our practice players. Yeah! Here they are in the corner. The band, Diana, there's a lot of media, Diana Koval, the band, the cheerleaders, the dance. And then lastly, you guys, 9 years ago, we probably averaged 500 fans. Okay, the book probably says 1,200, but literally it was about 500 people watching us play. And I didn't know what a national championship program looked like, because I was really so concentrating on the product that we put on the floor. But what you have done, what you have created in Colonial Life Arena, we can't write a book about it, because it was you. It was person by person spreading the news about creating this environment for our players. And when you've done that, we win national championships. And I don't want to get political. I don't want to get political, but I have to mention this. 2 years ago, our first trip to the Final Four was made possible to play a postseason game or two right here in the state of South Carolina because of a tragedy that happened, and the power of Nikki Haley, who decided to take the Confederate flag down to allow us to play. And also have to mention this. Last year when we lost in the Sweet 16, a lot of my friends and my family members said this: what's delayed is not denied.
Yeah. Yeah.
What's
yeah.
delayed is not denied. The Lord works in mysterious ways. He does. So if you're not a believer in him and you believe in us, you better find him, because he answers.
Yeah.
This is just the beginning. Thank you so very much from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you. To God be the glory.
Thank you, Gamecocks, for coming to celebrate the 2017 National Champions, your South Carolina women's basketball team. On behalf of the entire team and South Carolina Athletics Department, thank you to the City of Columbia and Richland County for helping making this possible. We'll see you in 6 months.